Shana Tova. Shana Tova.
Shana Tova.
Good morning. We'd like to ask Amanda and Aaron Kogan to come around to the side as well. And those who haven't can join me in the blessing over the talit, over the prayer shawl. Please rise and recite the bracha with me. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher kishanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lehitatef batzitzit. Amen.
Amen.
We wrap ourselves in the spirit of healing and forgiveness. And let's rise again and put your arm around your neighbor as we open our service with the Hine Matov U'Manaim. How beautiful when we live together in brotherhood, sisterhood, and peace.
Hine Matov U'Manaim, Shevet Achim Gam Yachad.
Hine Matov U'Manaim, Shevet Achim Gam Yachad. Hine Matov, Shevet Achim Gam Yachad. Hine Matov, Shevet Achim Gam Yachad. Hine Matov U'Manaim, 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 Shevet Achim Gam Yachad. Hine Matov, Hine Matov. Lai, 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 lai. Hine Matov, Hine Matov.
Please be seated, everyone, and let's read in unison on page 150. On the bottom of the page, please join me. With a feeling of much kindness, I enter into your very home. I stand in awe of this world which you have created, in love with all the earth, the dwelling place of your holy presence. I surrender myself in acknowledging your limitless potential and ask you for support. My God, my Creator, I will pray before you now at this special time. Answer me compassionately with your saving truth. Master of all the worlds, you instructed us in the sacrifices that were appropriate to the temple in Jerusalem. Although that temple is destroyed, we may now use the temple of our bodies to offer heartfelt prayer instead of sacrifice. May it be your will, our Redeemer and Center, that the prayer we offer up to you be pure, that our actions be timely, and that our highest visions be manifested as part of your ever-unfolding creation. Matovu.
Thank you.
Page 152, God of after sunset, God of half light and almost night, God of quiet and stillness, God of coolness that drifts up from the river, God of silhouetted leaves against a silvered sky, God of singing crickets and blinking fireflies, God of these, be my God too. Chatzi Kaddish, page 153. Page 154, let's read responsively on the bottom of the page. God searches all hearts on the day of judgment and reveals hidden things in judgment.
God bestows mercy on the day of judgment and remembers our covenant in judgment.
God spares all creatures on the day of judgment and clears those who trust in judgment.
God is clothed in charity on the day of judgment and pardons wrongdoing in judgment.
Page 154, let's rise to join in the chanting of the Baruch Hu, morning and evening, praising the Creator.
Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevodach.
Repeating together, praise the Lord, to whom our praise is due.
To whom our praise is due.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Please be seated, everyone, and let's turn back to page 133 for one of the traditional prayers of our liturgy known as the Yale, which means to ascend. And let's read in unison on the bottom of page 133, may our supplications, please join me. May our supplications rise at dusk. Our pleas approach you from dawn, and our thanksgiving praise you at dusk. May our words and deeds of penance rise at dusk. Our pardon come to greet us at dawn, and let atonement cleanse us at dusk. May our prayers of confession rise at dusk. Our remorse meet us at dawn, and let reconciliation make us whole at dusk. And I'd like to call on Aaron and Amanda Kogan for the Yale prayer, which is above the paragraph we just read in Hebrew, Yale tachanunenu me'arev.
Aleishenu Merev Vevotorenu Miboker Veerachinu Nenu Ararev Ya'ale
Zichroneinu
Merev Vevoviyudeinu Miboker Veerachad Rateinu Ararev
Yaledov Shateinu Adare
Yahaleh
Hein kateinu meret
Ve'yavo
Eleha
Mibo
Thank you, Amanda, Aaron. I'd like to call on Tom and Debbie Shapiro and family and Ray and Peggy Rosenthal and family to come up and open the ark for us. And let's all rise as we join together in the chanting of the Shema, the watchword of our faith. Repeating together, Hear, O Israel,
Hear, O Israel,
the Lord our God,
the Lord our God,
the Lord is one,
the Lord is one,
blessed is God's glorious kingdom,
blessed is God's glorious kingdom,
forever and ever,
forever and ever.
Please be seated, everyone. And is Eden, to the Viahafta. Eden, here she comes. Eden recently bat mitzvah, is going to lead us in the Viahafta. Page 156, let's join together with Eden in the Viahafta prayer, You Shall Love.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavcha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha ve'hayu hadvarim ha'ele אשר אנוכי מצווך היום על לבביך ושיננתם לבניך ודיברת בם ושבתך בביתך ובלכתך בדרך ושופך ובקומך וכשרתם לאות על ידיך, והיו לתוטפות בין עיניך, וכתבתם על מזוזות ביתך ובישריך.
Let's read in unison on the bottom of page 156, the Viahafta prayer. Please join me, everyone. You shall love Adonai, your creator, with all your passions, with every fiber of your being, with all that you possess. Let these words by which I join myself to you today enter into your heart. Pattern your days on them, that your children witness in you God's presence. Make your life a channel for God's holiness, both in your stillness and in your movement. Renew these words each morning and each evening. Bind them as signs upon your arm and head as symbols of acts and thoughts consecrated to me. Write them in mezuzot at the entrance to your home as a sign that all people may discover me as they enter your home and your life. On page 142, we have one of the beautiful prayers of our liturgy, the Shema Kolenu. Hear our voice, O Lord our God, and let's read in unison in English on page 142. Please join me. I'd like Beverly Todd to please come up. Now hear our voices, awaken all mercies, accept our prayer from where we are now. Bring us back to our center and we will return there with gladness. Renew us now as you have in days gone by. Cast us not away from before you. Take not your Holy Spirit away from us. As we grow older, do not abandon us. When we become weak, renew our faith and life. Release us from pain and strife. Remind us of who we are as we return to you.
All.
aleinu. V'kabel berachamim, berachamim uveratzon. Et tefilateinu.
Call on Beverly Todd at this time for a reading. And as our service continues, our children's service is taking place in the Gussman Founders Room. So if anyone has kids, grandkids, that's where our service for children will be taking place.
Good morning. We cannot expect you alone, O God, to end all wars. For you have meant for man to seek and find his own path to peace. We cannot expect you alone, O God, to end starvation and ignorance across the face of the earth. For you have given us tools with which to feed and educate ourselves, if only we would use them wisely. We cannot expect you alone, O God, to end hatred within our cities, for you have given us eyes with which to see the good in all men, if we would but open them. We cannot expect you alone, O God, to end all disease and pestilence, for you have given us the minds with which to conquer these evils, if we would only devote ourselves to these tasks. We cannot expect you alone, O God, to end the nagging tensions and frustrations in our daily lives, for you have revealed to us the way to bring serenity into our lives through love and dedication and Torah, if we would only choose this path. Author unknown. Thank you.
Ta'aretz ha'chayim ve'hamavet ha'bracha ve'haklala natati l'fanecha uv'acharta b'chayim uvacharta b'chayim l'ma'an, l'ma'an tichye.
Therefore, choose life.
I'd like to call on Martin Katz and Jamie McCourt to come up to open the Ark together with the Steve Leibowitz family. Please come up. And we turn in our prayer books to page 130 for the Amidah. Please rise while the Ark is open for the Amidah. The prayers acknowledging our Creator, God of our ancestors and our descendants.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Ve'lohe Avoteinu Ve'imoteinu Elohe Abraham Elohe Yitzhak Elohe Yaakov Elohe Sarah Elohe Rivka Elohe
Repeating with me, remember us to life.
Remember us to life.
O God who delights in life.
O God who delights in life.
And inscribe us in the book of life.
And inscribe us in the book of life.
For your sake.
For your sake.
O God of life.
O God of life.
Ata gibor le'olam Adonai, mechayeh meitim ata, rav lehoshia, mechagel chayim behesed, mechayeh meitim berachamim rabim, somech nachim berovei hoim, umatir
Because Yerushalayim, Yerushalayim, Irva. Ledor vador, ledor vador, ledor vador, ledor vador, netzach netzachim. Ledor vador, ledor vador, ledor vador, ledor vador, netzach netzachim. Ve'neinu tirena, tirena malchutecha.
You know what to do. Le door by door.
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 Le door by door. Door by door, nagir gan lacha.
Ulenetzach netzachim,
kedushatech nagdish,
kedushatech nagdish. Yeshivat Eloheinu, mipinu lo yavush, leolam leolam ba'el.
Le door by door,
le door by door,
le door by door,
le door by door,
nagir gan lacha. Le door by door,
le door by door,
le door by door,
le door by door. Remain standing for a moment of Amidah, silent meditation and prayer for any prayers in our hearts and minds this morning of Yom Kippur. And we dedicate a portion of our prayers to the men and women of our armed forces and to the soldiers of the Israel Defense Forces protecting her borders. We pray for a time when their sacrifice will no longer be needed as our world will live in peace. Please remain standing for a moment of Amidah, of silent meditation and prayer. Join in the Oseh Shalom, the prayer for peace.
Shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael.
like to call on Jeffrey and Gail Rosenthal family to come around to the side. And at this time, I'd like to call on Stephen Macht for a reading. Steve.
What can I do? I can speak up when others are silent. I can say man when others say money. I can stay awake when others fall asleep. I can keep working when others stop to play. I can give life deeper meanings when others think living has little value at all. I can love when others hate. I can support every man and woman when others choose one. I can judge events by a hard test when others take an easy way out. What can I do? I can give myself to life when others refuse.
Please turn to page 167. And this is the first of our morning confessional prayers. And as I've said before, in Jewish tradition, in terms of the liturgy, we don't confess privately to one person. We confess as a community all of the sins committed. And the tradition is to beat the heart into contrition, acknowledging that these are things that weigh on our heart that we need to correct. Please read with me on the bottom of page 167, responsively. Who are we? We are light and truth, infinite wisdom, eternal goodness, yet we have abused, we have betrayed, we've been cruel, and we have destroyed.
At our core, we are light and truth and infinite wisdom, eternal goodness, yet we have insulted, we have jeered, we have killed, we have lied.
Who are we? We are light and truth, infinite wisdom, eternal goodness, yet we have mocked, we have neglected, we have oppressed, we have perverted.
At our core, we are light and truth and infinite wisdom, eternal goodness. Yet we have quarreled, we have rebelled, we have stolen, we have transgressed.
Our real being is light and truth, infinite wisdom, eternal goodness. Yet we have been unkind, we've been violent, wicked, we've been xenophobic, and zealously self-righteous. Please rise, and we join together responsively with the cantor in the Ashamnu prayer.
Rashanu,
Shichatnu,
Please be seated, everyone. We continue with the second of our confessional prayers in our Yom Kippur service. On the bottom, in the middle of page 169, let's read responsively for the sin. For the sin of passing judgment without knowledge of the facts. For the sin of deceiving ourselves and others with half-truths. For the sin of using the shortcomings of others to excuse our own. For all these sins, O God of mercy, forgive us, pardon us, grant us atonement. We continue, and for the sin of failing to recognize our inclination to transfer responsibility.
For the sin we commit against ourselves when we are unwilling to hear the child within us and within others.
For the sin of tolerating the condition of the homeless and the poor.
And for the sin of turning a deaf ear to the cry of the oppressed.
Please join me. For all these sins, O God of mercy, forgive us, pardon us, grant us atonement. And we continue for the sin of keeping incompetent leaders in power.
And for the sin of failing to bring about needed change.
For the sin of obeying questionable orders.
And for the sin of silence and indifference.
For the sin of poisoning the air and polluting land and sea.
And for all the evil means we employ to accomplish good ends.
For the sin of confusing love with lust.
And for the sin of pursuing fleeting pleasure at the cost of lasting hurt.
Together, for all these, O God of mercy, forgive us, pardon us, grant us atonement. And I'd like to call at this time on Michael Carlin and Natalie Carlin to come up to open the Ark for us together with Jeff and Gail Rosenthal. Our service continues with the final reading of this Al Chet. Teach us to forgive ourselves and others for all these sins we have enumerated, O forgiving God, and help us to overcome them. Our service continues on page 171. And let's read responsively the Avinu Malkeinu prayer in its interpretive translation. Please join with me on the top of page 171. Our source and our deep inner guide, we have let ourselves move from the truth.
O Mother, our nurturing guide, make yourself known through us.
O Father, our guide on the way, renew for us now a good year.
Our source and our...
O Mother, our guide on the way, let our darkness be illumined with light. Our source, our deep inner guide, let us return to God in all things. O Father, our guide on the way, yes, we know that we are but dust. O Mother, our guide on the way, may we find the ways to rid our world of oppression and evil. Please rise as the ark is opened and we join together in a moment in the Avinu Malkeinu, first the prayers asking God to inscribe us for health and well-being in a new year.
Avinu Malkeinu, Chaneinu Anenu.
be seated, everyone. And I'd like to call up a couple for a blessing of the soon-to-be-weds, Michael and Natalie. Michael, Natalie, come on up. Michael is one of our temple treasurers, so he makes sure that the rabbi's Hawaii getaway fund is always well-funded and secure. Michael, Natalie, we're so thrilled that both of you be entering under the chuppah very soon, just a matter of days, weeks. And we pray that Hashem, that the Almighty Source of Healing, grant you a blessing of long-lasting love, health, well-being, companionship, and the precious blessing of wholeness and peace. Amen.
Amen.
We can pray for many things in our life. Of course, health, life itself. But without this blessing, all of it fades away. And that blessing is the blessing of peace. Sim Shalom.
Sim Shalom, Tova uvracha ba'olam, Chein v'chesed, v'rachamim aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha.
Lechaim.
Moseh HaShalom. Amen.
I'd like to call at this time for Rabbi Neil Weinberg and the students of Judaism by Choice to please come around for an ark opening in just a moment. And Vicki Mentz and her family, together with Natalie and Danny and Stephen, Marcella, please come around for the next ark opening, which will be happening in just a moment. And the ark opening will be for the taking out of the Torah, and we'll be marching through the congregation and upstairs for everyone to have an opportunity to kiss the Torah. And the Torah portion is the powerful portion of Acharei Mot, after the death of the two sons of Aaron. And it's a portion that describes within it, of course, the rituals that we're observing today of Yom Kippur. And that ritual was one where only once a year, on Yom Kippur, could the high priest, the Kohen Gadol, enter into the inner sanctum of the Holy Temple. And he would offer a prayer. And the sequence of the prayer is fascinating because it goes against what we would normally think would be the sequence of a prayer by such an important religious leader. Instead of praying for the people first and then his family and himself, he prayed first for himself. And the tradition teaches us that we have to be whole and at peace ourselves before we can benefit our families or benefit humanity. It starts with me. It starts with you. That's the initial prayer, and that's the focus of prayer today as we look within and evaluate any mistakes, wrongdoings, or sins we may have committed in the past year. And I'll be announcing the Torah page, but right now to come up for the sequence of Aliyot to the Torah, I'd like to call on the Bilak family, Ed and Marie Lewis, Jeff and Macy Green and family, Matt and Marsha Lichtenberg with their sons. Please come around this side to prepare for the Aliyah to the Torah. So our service continues with the prayer before the Ark, and it can be found in our prayer books on page 55. Let's read together on page 55 for Hotzaat HaTorah. Above the din of a noisy world, speak to us with the still small voice of your spirit. Please join me. If our lives have become shallow, deepen them. If our principles have become shabby, repair them. If our ideals have become tarnished, restore them. If our hopes have become faded, revive them. If our loyalties have grown dim, brighten them. If our values have become confused, clarify them. If our purposes have become blurred, sharpen them. If our horizons have become contracted, widen them. If our hearts have been chilled by indifference, warm them with your mercy and with the glowing spirit of your holy Torah. Amen.
Malchut kol olamim, umemshalteva bechol dor v'hador. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai yilov, le'olam v'ed. Adonai oz le'amo yiten, Adonai yevarech et amo. Shalom, Abraham Avim, Ketiv Avir Zonecha, Et
call on Vicky Mentz and family to come up and open the ark, and let us rise as the ark is open for Kimitzion.
Vayhi ben soach ha'adom, vayomer Moshe, kuma Adonai, ve'afutsu oyavecha, ve'yanusu mesanecha, mipanecha.
Page 57, repeating with me the 13 attributes of the divine. The Lord God is gracious and compassionate, patient, abounding in kindness and faithfulness, assuring love for a thousand generations, forgiving iniquity, transgression, and sin, and granting pardon. Rabbi Weinberg and his students from Judaism by Choice. This is a special moment for the Jewish people, as we want to acknowledge all the men and women who've come into the Jewish faith, who will deepen and enrich our heritage. And on this day, come on a little closer. Let's. Neil, your class is exploding.
I know it is.
I know that. We're bringing in a lot of new MOTs, members of our tribe. That's wonderful. Well, we welcome all of you, and as a Jewish community, we say you are a part of our present and our future, even as we look back to the past to find inspiration. And as you have declared your commitment to keeping the ideals and values of Judaism and Torah, you inspire us to deepen our commitment. And we offer now for each and every one of you a blessing. May God watch over you and protect you. May you do everything to enhance and enrich your personal religious lives and this journey that you've undertaken. And we welcome you warmly. And you'll be joining us in chanting the Shema in just a moment, the declaration of our faith as we take the Torah from the Ark. Does Nate have a Torah?
Adonai Eloheinu
Thank you.
Please be seated, everyone. Please be seated. Today's Torah reading for Yom Kippur can be found on pages 66, 67, and 68. And it speaks also about a very important component of this day, which is known as Ve'initem et nafshotechem, to afflict your souls. To, in other words, not engage in the joyful activity that we do during the course, but to abstain, to pull in, to withdraw to some degree, abstaining from food, drink, sexual relations, wearing of leather. In ancient days, there were two kinds of people, people who could afford a pair of leather sandals and those who walked barefoot. So it was considered a form of luxurious living. And also, one tradition claims that an animal had to be killed to fashion that product, and we don't want to be involved in killing under any circumstances, not humans, not animal life. In fact, very interesting commentary, when an ancient Israelite soldier would go out to battle, he would probably have to kill to defend himself and his family, and so he would offer a half a shekel, machatzit shekel, as an atonement for having to kill. Because even though he was killing to defend himself and his family, killing inherently was wrong. And so he was making a redemption, a kofar, a kapara, an atonement for the act that he would have to commit in defense of himself and his family. And this concept of atonement is very ancient, and it goes back to the offering at the time the high priest would enter into the Holy of Holies. And in fact, he would recite God's name in a way that we've lost. We don't know how the name of God is actually recited anymore. Those letters are incomprehensible in terms of putting together the pronunciation. Only the high priest knew it, and it was a tradition that was not passed down through the generations. But he was so moved by the prayer and so overcome with emotion that when he went in, they would tie a rope around his waist in case he fainted and passed out so they could pull him out of the inner sanctum of the Holy Temple. But again, he prayed, as I said, first for himself, then for his family, then for the people. And the other component of the Torah reading deals with the scapegoat. The scapegoat, the idea that were two goats that were sent off, one sent off to the wilderness, one offered as a sacrifice, and upon it were placed the sins of the people, so that no human being would have to suffer on account of anyone else. And that's another powerful example of the lesson that in the Jewish faith, we have no such thing as vicarious atonement, that someone else can die for your sins. In Judaism, if you've committed a sin, you have to make it right between yourself and the Creator, or between yourself and your fellow man or woman. There's no vicarious atonement. There's no easy out. You have to do the work of healing and atonement. That's our obligation in the Jewish faith. So we're going to begin our Torah reading, and I'm going to start by calling for the first Aliyah, the Lichtenbergs and the Bilak family. Please come up for the first Aliyah to the Torah. The Lichtenbergs there. Thank you. take the first blessing. The Baruch Hu. Yeah, Zacharimos, yeah. Okay, you can touch the Torah. It's inside. Yeah? You guys will do the first blessing and you'll do the second blessing. Okay, go ahead. One, two, three. Baruch Hu.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam.
Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim Ve'natan Lanu Et Toratu.
Baruch Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen. Vaydaber Adonai El Moshe Acharei Mot Shnei Bnei Aharon Bekarav Tam Lifnei Adonai Ve'yamutu Vayomer Adonai El Moshe Daber El Haron Achicha Ve'al Yavo Bechol Eit El HaKodesh Mibeit Leparochet Al Pnei HaKaporet Asher Al Aron Ve'lo Yamut Ki Be'anan Eirae Al HaKaporet Bezot Yavo Aron El HaKodesh Befar Bein Bakar Lechatat Yail Leolah.
Now step forward in the second blessing. Come on up together. One, two, three.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lanu Torat Emet Mechaye Yolam Nata Betochenu Baruch Atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. And we call up to the Torah for the next Aliyah, Jeff and Macy Green and family. And Johnny, Rob, and Miley Ellen, please come up.
Baruch
Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bacha Banu Mikol Hamim V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen. Kedonet Bad Kodesh Yilbash Umidrasei Vad Iyo Besaro Uvenet Biyadach Gor Ubinetzet Bad Yitznov Bigdei Kodesh Heim Verachatz Bamaim Et Besaro Ulvesham Umeit Adat Bnei Yisrael Yikach Shnei Seirei Izim Lachatat V'ayilechat Le'olah V'ikriv Aharon Et Parachatat Asher Lo V'chiper Bado
U'bad
Beito.
Baruch Atah Adonai
Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lanu Torat Emet Vayeolam Natan Melodenu Baruch Atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
See you. Good job. You remembered it. And we call up to the Torah for the next Aliyah, Ed and Marie Lewis. You want me to take over? You got it? Okay, you got it on a roll? You're on a roll. Don't talk about rolls now, I'm hungry. Told the cantor he's on a roll, but he said, don't talk about food, it's Yom Kippur. Come on up over here. And this blessing right here.
Where is he? Oh, no, I got this one.
Oh, good. Okay. Baruch Hu.
Baruch et Adonai Hamavorach.
Baruch Adonai Barach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamavorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Amim Vatilanu Et Toratu. Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen. V'lakach et Shnei Hasirim V'midotam Lifnei Adonai Petach Ohel Moed. Benatan Aharon al shnei asirim goralot goral echad l'Adonai v'goral echad l'Azazel v'kriv Aharon et ha-sa'ir asher ala alav ha-goral l'Adonai v'asahu chatat v'ha-sa'ir asher ala alav ha-goral l'Azazel v'yamad Hai lifnei Adonai lechaper alav leshalach oto lazazel hamidbara v'ikriv Aharon et parachatat asher lo v'chiper badov ad beito v'shachat et parachatat asher lo.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Asher Natan Lanu Torat Emet Vahi Olam Natan Batahinu Baruch ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Well done, Eddie. Well done, well done. Well done, well done. Now for the last Aliyah, I'm going to invite everyone to join me in the Torah blessings. And I'll read this last one, maybe. Okay. And what page of the Torah blessings are? On page 58, please join with me and take this aliyah together with me as your rabbi, participating in the blessings of the Torah. Please join me. Baruchu et Adonai Hamvorach, Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim Venatan Lanu et Torato, Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah. Shabbat Shabbaton, ilachem initem et nafshotechem, chukat olam, v'chiper ha-kohen, asher yimshach oto, v'asher yimale et yado l'chahen, tachat aviv, v'lavash et bigdei habad, bigdei kodesh, v'chiper et mikdash ha-kodesh, v'et ohel moed, v'et ha-mizbeach yichaper, v'al ha-kohanim, v'al kolam ha-kahal yichaper, v'ayta zot lachem l'chukat olam l'chaper al b'nei Yisrael. And this shall be an eternal sign of atonement between me and the children of Israel for all eternity, atonement for all their sins. Mikol chatotam achat bashana vayask asher tziva Adonai et Moshe. And we join in the second blessing. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu torat emet v'chaye olam nata betochenu. Baruch ata Adonai Noten HaTorah. And I'd like to call on Dr. Malcolm Lesavoy and Pat Lesavoy for the lifting and the tying of the Torah scroll. Let's rise as the scroll is lifted. Vezot HaTorah
Asher Samoshe Lifnei Bnei Yisrael Lapi Adonai Liyad Moshe.
Pat, you're going to tie in. Please be seated, everyone. Today's Haftorah reading is one of the most powerful from all the prophets. It's from the prophet Isaiah, who describes what a true fast should be for the Jewish people, not a fast that is perfunctory, but one that is true. And if you look at the words on page 80,
Is this the fast I desire, a day for men to starve their bodies? Bowing their head like a bulrush and lying in sackcloth and ashes, do you call that a fast? A day when the Lord is favorable? No. This is the fast I desire. Unlock the fetters of wickedness. Untie the cords of the yoke. Let the oppressed go free to break off every yoke. Share bread with the hungry. Take the wretched poor into your home. When you see the naked, clothe them, and do not ignore your kin. Then and only then shall your light burst forth through like the dawn, and your healing spring up quickly. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar b'nevi'im tovim v'ratza v'divreihem ha'ne'marim b'emet. Baruch atah Adonai habocher b'torah uv'moshe avdo uv'Yisrael amo uv'nevi'ei ha'emet v'tzedek. You can follow the Haftorah reading in Hebrew on page 79 and its translation on pages 80 and 81. Hachazeh yetzom evcharehu yom anot adam nafsho halachov keagmon rosho v'sak v'efer yatzia halozeh tikratzom V'yom ratzon l'adonai, haloze tzom avcharehu, pitach harbutzot resha, hater agudot mota, v'shalach ritzutzim chofshim, v'chol mota tenateku, oz titanag el adonai, v'hirchavticha al bamatei haaretz, V'achalti chanachalat Yaakov avicha, ki pi Adonai diber. And we continue with the blessing, concluding the Haftarah on page 74. Al HaTorah v'al Avodah v'al Nevi'im v'al Yom HaKippurim hazeh, Shenatata lanu Adonai Eloheinu limichila velislicha ulechapara lechavod uletifaret. Ala kol Adonai Eloheinu anachnu modim lach umvarchim otach yitbarach shimcha befi kol chai tamid liolam ba'ed udvarcha emet vekayam lahad baruch ata Adonai. Praised are you, O God, melech mochel v'soleach lavonotenu, the God who heals and forgives our sins, v'lavonot amo beit Yisrael, and to the sins of the people, u'ma'avir ashmoteinu b'chol shana v'shana, and causes our sins and guilt to pass year by year. Melech al kol haaretz mekadesh Yisrael, melech al kol haaretz mekadesh Yisrael, melech al kol haaretz mekadesh Yisrael, V'yom HaKippurim. Amen. Praised are you, O God, who sanctifies our people and the Day of Atonement. Let's turn to the prayer for our country, which can be found on page 89, and I'd like to ask you to join with me. Our country needs a prayer for coming together in unity more than ever. It's a prayer for our congregation and Israel as well. Please join me. Our God and God of our ancestors, may your blessings be granted to us and our loved ones. Grant us kindness and compassion, health and well-being. Sustain all people throughout the world on this new year. Vouchsafe your blessings of peace and tranquility to the state of Israel, our ancestral homeland, and to our nation, these United States of America. Unite all the inhabitants of our country in a bond of brotherhood to banish hatred and safeguard our ideals and institutions of freedom. Amen. And I'd like to call at this time for the opening of the Ark, Jim and Blanche Blatt, Paige and Ellen, and Erwin and Lynn Deutsch, please come up As we'll be returning the Torah scroll to the Ark, you can come up these stairs very close by. Please come up. Jim and Blanche, the family. Please rise as the Ark is opened. Seated, everyone. We're approaching the hour of memory, the Yizkor hour. And Yom Kippur is many things, and one of the things it is about preserving memory and preserving life. Thank you. And as we preserve life, we think back on people who impacted our lives, who made a strong, soulful impression on us. And we realize that it's our commitment and responsibility to preserve those memories. And there are some very special people that I think of besides my mother and father, and I'm sure many of you are going to be thinking about your parents and loved ones on Yom Kippur at the Yizkor Hour, brothers and sisters, husbands and wives, even very close friends who become like family. And as we think about them and cherish their memory, we also acknowledge that on one hand, the memories are sad, but on the other hand, how lucky were we to have these people in our lives? What a blessing, what a gift it was. And I'm thinking today about a few people. One was a very beloved member of our congregation who died this year, Jerry Moss. And Jerry, many of you may know him from his partnership with Herb Alpert and A&M Records. Jerry was a legend in that industry. But I had certain fond recollections related to Yom Kippur. I remember one year, Jerry came into the synagogue right after his horse, Giacomo, won the Kentucky Derby, 60-1 odds. And I looked down at him and I said, Jerry, why didn't you tell us? We would have bet the temple treasury and we would have paid off our mortgage. And he looked right up at me and he said, Rabbi, don't you think if I knew my horse was going to win, I would have bet more money on it myself? And the other comment that Jerry made that was really touched my heart and opened my mind, and I think that's what people in our lives have the opportunity to do, especially those that we're close to. They have a way of opening up our consciousness because they can say things to us that maybe a stranger can't, although sometimes strangers do. The other thing he said, you know, Rabbi, you do this beautiful prayer for the men and women of the armed forces, and this was around the time of the Iraq War. He said, what about all those innocent civilians, that collateral damage, those human beings who were killed? Can't we say a prayer for them? And I said, wow, what a heart. You're absolutely right. We're going to include them in our prayers and thoughts. So people can have an impact on you in the way they see the world and open your horizons and perspectives. But you have to feel that it's an important obligation and responsibility to preserve memory. And that's what the Jewish people are about, preserving the memories. The other person who died this past year was someone who many of us remember. His name was Daniel Ellsberg. Daniel Ellsberg, if you recall, was tried for treason and going to be sentenced to 117 years in prison for releasing what were known at the time as the Pentagon Papers. A nice Jewish boy from a Jewish family who became an expert in nuclear proliferation, an expert at the Rand Corporation, and he released the Pentagon Papers, which told us that our government was lying to us, the Pentagon was lying to us about the number of troops being killed in Vietnam. And that, of course, opened the floodgates. Now, you may not agree with him, but he said, I admire, before he died, he said, I admire WikiLeaks and its founder, Julian Assange, and I admire those who call the government to task when they feel an injustice is occurring or a lie is being perpetrated on the people. And that was Daniel Ellsberg, came from humble roots. And the third person that I remember is someone really remarkable. He grew up in the Bensonhurst section of Brooklyn, and he showed a tremendous proficiency in science. And his parents saw that in an early age. Both of his parents were immigrants who came from Ukraine. And they lost so many loved ones in the Holocaust. They were very deeply saddened. But they kept it from their young son, Carl, who was named for his maternal grandmother, Chaika. And they didn't want to ruin his optimism and his look at the world and the universe. And he grew up to become Harvard professor, astrophysicist Carl Sagan. And Carl had an interesting way of looking at the world. When the first shots came back of planet Earth, the little blue ball, he said, look again at that dot. That's there. That's here. That's our home. That's us. On it is everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives, the aggregate of all of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, economic doctrines, every hunter, every forager, every hero, every coward, every creator and destroyer of civilization, every king, every peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, every hopeful child, inventor, explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there on that little mote of dust we call Earth, suspended on a sunbeam. And his brilliance, for those of you who remember the epic series Cosmos, talked about exploring the universe. And he established SETI, the search for extraterrestrial life and intelligence in the universe. He was a believer in that. And Carl Sagan was also someone who struggled, because when he discovered how many of his relatives had been killed by the Nazis, he realized that he could not let that go. And in his work, Shadow of Forgotten Ancestors, he talks about the struggle of how his parents kept this from him to keep his optimism and wide-eyed look at the universe, but that tragedy shaped him and formed a lot of his beliefs. So he's someone else who had an impact on us, who's gone, but the impact is still felt. And that's because we treasure memory. That's one of the dimensions of Jewish peoplehood. Treasuring memory. And memory comes to us in many ways and shapes and forms. For some, it's a smell of a familiar dish that our grandmother made. For some of us, it's a voice. And you know, I know so many friends who, after they've lost a loved one, they kept their loved one's recording on the voice message just so they could call it and listen again and again. And that reconnected them. So there are many different components to this thing we call memory, and one of them is the artifacts, the religious artifacts that are so precious. And someone I'm very proud to call a new friend, Johnny Daniels, and I'm going to call him up. He's been involved in preserving those precious artifacts. And let's take a moment and look at his work through his organization called From the Depths. Interesting, From the Depths is actually a psalm. From the depths I call to you, O Lord. Hear my voice, hear my prayer. So if we can lower the screen, we're going to take a look at some of what he's been doing in Eastern Europe to preserve memories from the depths. Where's Johnny?
And this is about a Holocaust Torah scroll that was rescued.
Scroll hidden during the Holocaust, unseen for 75 years, has reemerged and is being rewritten by Holocaust survivors.
It's on a journey to survivors around the world, and today it was unfurled right here in Toronto for residents at Baycrest. CTV's Raheem Ladani was there.
With every word etched by this quill with ink and arms linked with Holocaust survivors, this historic Torah scroll is being brought back to life.
You did a great job.
It brings me memories back from years and years ago.
At 95 years old, Ruth Berneman says she's lived through a lot of tragedy, but seeing this artifact is a testament to her faith.
It means assurance of our existence.
In 1939, the rabbi of a Polish village gave this Torah scroll to his non-Jewish neighbor before being deported.
The rabbi, unfortunately, was killed that very day in Treblinka concentration camp. This Torah was hidden, undiscovered for 75 years.
A Jewish group recovered the severely damaged scroll from a shepherd's home and is using parchment made from the skin of a kosher animal to restore the sacred teachings and ensure survivors, like Mila Dorczyk, born in Poland with more than 100 members of her family sent to concentration camps, that their voices are heard.
To lose the whole family, that what was the life of the concentration camp. How can I feel?
This Torah scroll is traveling around the world, and there are still more than 100,000 letters to be filled in, with every step seen as a mitzvah.
A mitzvah is a good deed, an act of importance within the Jewish tradition.
Once complete, this empowering legacy will be placed in a synagogue inside the residence of the President of Israel and used as a teaching tool to ensure the tragedy never fades and lessons live on. Raheem Ladani, CTV.
Thank you. We can lift the screen. And now it's my pleasure to call on Johnny Daniels to tell us a little more about this scroll and where it came from. Johnny, come on up. Shana Tova. Welcome. Good to have you here. So Johnny, tell us the story of this scroll. How did you get to this little village in the first place where you found this scroll? Who found it and how was it identified? And what was the story of how it was kept?
So we run a foundation called From the Depths. From the Depths is an organization that works to remember the Holocaust, to ensure that the young generations continue to learn from its message and to make sure that we push this to the next generation as well. And we'd partnered with students from Poland, Polish students from the University of Warsaw.
Jewish, non-Jewish?
Non-Jewish students from the University of Warsaw. There are not too many Jewish students in the University of Warsaw today, unfortunately. Yeah. And we'd sent these students to different geographical areas around the country, specifically places where pre-war there were large Jewish communities. In Poland alone was the largest pre-war Jewish community almost in the entire world. 3.5 million Jews lived in Poland, almost all of them sadly murdered during the Holocaust. So we send the students to different geographical areas where we know that there were Jewish communities, where we know that people lived, where there were vibrant Jewish lives. And the students go from house to house speaking to locals, attempting to uncover anything connected to our past. Sadly, often we discover many difficult things, all the way from mass graves of Jews who are unknown. Entire villages wiped out, and discovering these stories enables us to make sure that these people are remembered and continue to be remembered.
So a student told you that there was something being held by someone.
Yes, absolutely. So what happened was is that the students ended up in the home of a Polish shepherd, a very simple man. I say home, it was more like a shack. And they sat there with this shepherd and explained to him, they gave them the spiel, we're looking for anything connected to Jewish heritage and history. He started to get uncomfortable. His wife came out from the kitchen and she said, Yashul, tell them. And he said, listen, He said, I was a young boy when the war broke out. I remember the day very clearly. I was 6 years old. And I sat there watching as the Jews were being taken. I saw my neighbor, a rabbi, an old man with a long white beard, and I watched as he was being walked to the city of, to the center of the shtetl. And then I saw something entirely peculiar that I'd never seen before. I see this rabbi starting to run. But this is an old man running. It looks like he's running in slow motion. I was transfixed. I couldn't move my eyes. And then suddenly the rabbi looks up and looks directly at me. He said, I screamed and my father noticed that I was looking, pulled me away, shut the curtains and said, do not watch. And a few minutes later, there's banging on the front door. My father, petrified, went to the front door, he told us. And he said, I was a kid, I was interested, I went with him. I stood there holding his trouser leg to see who was there. And standing there was the rabbi. He was sweating, he was crying, he was nervous, and he had something in his arms. And he pushed this onto my father. And he said, look after this until I return, or another Jew comes and knows what to do. And then the rabbi disappeared. So the students asked him, they said, please tell us, what was it? What did he give you? And he said, are any of you Jewish? They said, no. He said, well, I can't tell you then. He said, whoa, 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 we know a Jew. So the Jew came via the back entrance, and I entered the house of the shepherd, and he looked at me, and he burst out crying. And he said, I've been waiting for you for 75 years. He took me into his living room. He lifted up the sofa. And lying on the floor was half of a Torah scroll.
Half.
Half. Shocked, I picked up this Torah, held it in my arms, thanked him profusely. Then suddenly I realized that there's half. And I said, tell me, how come half? He said, well, we used half of it. I made my wife a handbag, insoles for shoes, not out of malice. They didn't know any better. So at that very moment, I decided that rather than burying this Torah, which is what would be done according to Jewish tradition of a Torah that's been desecrated, we'd need to bring this scroll back to life. This rabbi, we later found out, along with the rest of the Jews of Filipov, this small town in northern Poland, were all sent to Treblinka that very day. Treblinka extermination camp. Every single one of those Jews was murdered that day. This rabbi didn't realize what was going to happen to him that day, but he risked his life, nevertheless, to attempt to save this Torah. This Torah that then befell on me then very much felt like my responsibility to ensure that this Torah continues, that this book that symbolizes us as a people continues. So we set out on a mission to rewrite the missing part of this Torah, letter by letter by letter, and the only people writing the letters in this Torah are Holocaust survivors themselves.
Yes, and we had one of our congregants, a Holocaust survivor, David Wiener, wrote letters. He must have written about 8 letters for his brothers and sisters who were killed by the Nazis and by his parents. And we also had Joe here, who's 101 years old. He wrote one of the letters in the Sefer Torah. And the idea that this can come to life by survivors, something that's a precious legacy of the Jewish people, something we hold dear, that's a part of our consciousness. Now, you were saying that your organization, From the Depths, also tries to help men and women who were rescuers of the Holocaust. From what I have studied, in Europe, if you hit a Jew or a Jewish family, you'd be killed, you'd be executed. But in Poland, it was even more severe. You and your entire family would be executed. And you found surviving rescuers, is that correct?
Correct. So from Yad Vashem, as we know, honored the righteous amongst the nations, as they're known, righteous Gentiles. Oskar Schindler, many would have heard of, but there were 27,000 others as well. Non-Jews who stood up when the times were hard, who stood against the tide and saved our Jewish brothers and sisters during the war. And from this 27,000, when we started working with them about 6 years ago, there were about 700 to 800 alive.
That's it.
Today, There's just 100 left in the whole world.
And your organization brings them food and medical supplies?
What we found, unfortunately, was that most of these people have been forgotten by history, that they were honored, but then sadly forgotten. So we spent the last 5-6 years traveling all the way through Eastern Europe, all the way down to Albania, where the last Muslim righteous is still alive, to honor them, to support them, and to give them everything they need, from operations to car services, just to make sure that these heroes are treated the way they should be as heroes.
This is a concept in Judaism called recognizing the good, Hakarat Hatov. So many of us know the names of the killers and the mass murderers, but how many of us know the names of the good? And preserving their memory is something the Jewish people are commanded to do. And I want to thank you, Johnny, for the work you do through your organization, flying into Eastern Europe and sometimes to Ukraine, a war zone, and other places to seek out the rescuers and to preserve the precious legacy of religious artifacts.
Shana tova.
Thank you. Thank you. So that's a breathtaking story, and there are so many others, and they're part of our history, part of our heritage, part of what we preserve. And as we come to a Yizkor hour, the hour of memory, when we remember parents and loved ones, dear ones who are no longer here, but who are a blessing to us, think about something else they passed on, our Jewishness, our Jewish heritage. Maybe in the foods they cooked, in the meals they shared, in the Passover dinners, in the Shabbat dinners, whatever it might have been, in the greeting, in the loving glance, in the warm embrace. These are memories that are eternal, and our heritage is intricately interwoven into that heritage. And it's one that we're all duty-bound to preserve. May God help us preserve it in the coming year. Amen. We're going to take a moment to offer a prayer. Alicia, heal us now. We're going to offer a prayer of healing. In Jewish tradition, we say a prayer for those who are ill, people who are undergone surgery or a recent hospitalization. And all of us know someone who's going through a medical crisis, and we want to offer a prayer for their recovery. And that prayer is one that we are going to do now, heal us now. Is that correct? We need Sharon. Oh, there she is. Okay. They're going to join in, heal us now. So in Jewish tradition, there are two healing prayers, Misha Beirach, which we are all familiar with, and also words that are taken, words that Moses spoke when his sister Miriam was stricken with leprosy. And he said, Ana Elna Refana La, dear God, please heal her now. And that has been taken to meaning healing all of us, not just one person's sister, but Ana Elna Refana La, dear God, heal us now. And this prayer comes from our tradition, and we're going to ask our cantors to sing it. And think of someone you know or love who's going through a medical crisis, and let's take them into our hearts and pray that the Almighty grants them a healing of body and soul on this sacred and holy day of Yom Kippur. And let us say, Amen.
Amen.
Refa'enu Adonai b'nei rafet, hoshienu b'nivashaya. Soul.
Hoshia et amecha, uvarech et achlatecha.
Ureem v'nasem ad ha'olam. Mishaberach avoteinu, mishaberach imoteinu. Adonai, Adonai, Hoshia.
To begin our Yizkor memorial service in just a moment. And, you know, some people feel they have to leave. You don't have to leave. You can say a Yizkor prayer for a friend who died or a relative. It doesn't have to be a parent. There's that old superstition, well, if my parents are alive, I don't want to stay in the Yizkor service. But that's a superstition because Yizkor is a prayer we can say in memory of anyone. And right now I'd like to call up U.S. Army Specialist Christina Calderon, who's going to join our memorial table. Yizkor, the hour of memory, a time when we embrace the souls of our loved ones who are no longer here with us. And we begin acknowledging the ultimate sacrifice by the men and women of our armed forces and the soldiers of the Israel Defense Forces. Serve in the armed forces of our country and in the armed forces of Tzahal, the Israel Defense Forces, who were called upon to defend and protect each and every one of us and our rights and freedoms. And Adrian is going to share a song that speaks to the heart of their unity, shoulder to shoulder, as men and women in uniform, a true band, a band of brothers and sisters.
Requiem for a soldier.
Mm-hmm. to me. One shining dream of hope and love, life and liberty.
God, watch over the souls of our brave men and women who serve our country and protect our freedoms. Can take up the screen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your service. I'd like to call on Sarah Gurian, who's going to join with Cantor Nate in chanting the melody that was the signature melody of remembering the 6 million men, women, and children, 1.5 million of them children, murdered by the Nazis in the Shoah. And the melody is, Ani Ma'amin, I believe fervently that even though the Messiah tarries, the Messiah will yet come. And as Brent, a fire burns, destroying our people, but the fire in our hearts remains strong.
Amen. Mashiach ani ma'amin.
Ani ma'amin. Ani ma'amin. Ani ma'amin.
Esprend, Bridelach, Esprend, Oi unser Orem Steitel Nebech, Brennt. Beisen mit in Bittier Gosen, Reißen, Brechen, unser Blosen, Starker noch die wilde Flammen, Als er umschoin brennt. Und entsteht und kucht, Also is ich, mit verlechte Händ. Und entsteht und kucht, Also is ich, unser Städtel brennt. It burns, my brothers dear, it burns. Our poor little Städtel is on fire. Furiously angry windstorm, madly around the whip flames swarm. Ever wilder grows the fierce flames, everything's on fire. And you stand around and stare, while the flames grow higher. And you stand around and stare, while our Städtel burns. Es brennt, Bridelach, es brennt.
These candles on our memorial table burn in memory of the 6 million, in memory of all of our loved ones and dear ones whom we call to memory today. And please, repeating with me the best loved of our Hebrew Psalms, the 23rd. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures, leading me beside the still waters, restoring my soul. He guideth me in straight paths for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Gam ki elech, the 23rd Psalm.
Ki elech b'geh tzar mavet lo 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 idara gam ki elech b'geh tzar mavet lo 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 idara. Oh,
I'd like to call on Faye Arfa and her brother, who was born in a displaced persons camp, to stand at the table in memory of their parents, grandparents, and loved ones who perished in the Holocaust. The second generation and the third generation are who we look upon to preserve those memories, the memories of our ancestors and loved ones who were so brutally murdered. So we're going to pause for a moment of silence as they stand here at the table to recall their loved ones. May their souls be a continuous blessing for each and every one of us as we cherish their memory, and their death is not in vain. It's a part of our consciousness forever. What do we want from life? Just to enjoy life, to live life, the fullness of life. And when we lose loved ones before their time, it's very painful. And to sing one of the beautiful psalms, Mi ha'ish ha'chafetz chayim, who is the one who seeks life, just to see good days, to see goodness in the world. I'd like to call on the father of slain Wall Street Journal reporter Danny Pearl, whose memory we keep alive with music months every year, Dr. Judea Pearl, to sing, Mi ha'ish, who is that man who seeks nothing more than a full life?
Mi ha'ish echafetz chayim ohev yamim אוהב ימים לראות טוב. חפץ חיים. אוהב ימים לראות טוב. Shalom verot vehu mi ha'ish chayim echafetz chayim chayim
At a time like this, many of us remember mothers. We can dim the lights a bit, please. Many of us remember mothers and grandmothers who tended us and cared for us and watched over us and protected us in that special and unique way, the way of the mamala, the mother deer.
Mamele, mamele, mother dear, I'll always call you mamele. Tired eyes, wrinkled hands, but a simple heart that always understands. I remember how you used to comfort me, a little boy of three, in bygone years. I remember how you put me on your knee, with a kiss you would dry my tears. Mamele, mamele, mother dear, I'll always call you mamele, mamele, mamele. May God bless you, mamele. Mamele, mamele, mit Liebschach will ich riefen dich, mamele. Eugen Mied, schwach dein Hand, a golden heart hast die, und jedes Kind verstehst. Ich gedenk, wie die wächst, mich blühigen, a Kind von dreier Bläus, ich darf dich sehr. Wie die flechst mich setzen, da muss auf dein Scheuß, mit der Kisch, auf Gewicht, jeden Tränen. Mamele, weiß dein Kopf, Gott, wie es tiet bald, wusst die wes grollt alt. Mamele, Mamele, sei gebensch von Gott, Mamele, 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 sei gebensch von Gott, Mamele. Mamele.
And many of us remember fathers and grandfathers who provided for us, who held us dear, who guided us and tended us and gave us the best of themselves.
Back when I was a child, before life removed all the innocence, my father would lift me high and dance with my mother and me, and then spin me round till I fell asleep. Then up the stairs he would carry me, and I knew for sure I was loved. If I could get another chance, another walk, another dance with him, I'd play a song that would never ever end, 'cause I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. would run from her to him. He'd make me laugh just to comfort me. Oh, finally make me do just what my mother said. Later that night when I fell asleep, he left a dollar under my sheet. Every dream that he would be gone for me. If I could steal one final glance, one final step, one final dance with him, I'd play a song that would never ever end. 'Cause I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Sometimes I'd listen outside her door, and I'd hear how my mother cry for him. I pray for her even more than me. I pray for her even more than me. I know I'm praying for much too much, but could you send back the only man she loved? I know you don't do that usually, but dear Lord, she's dying to dance with my father again. Every night I fall asleep, and this is all I dream.
And many of us have lost loved ones, husbands, wives, brothers, sisters, tragically, most of deeply tragically, children. And yet we see them in different places, in different moments, perhaps at the moon, as we glance at the moon, perhaps as we come to a cafe that looks familiar, a place we sat and chatted and shared life's experience. We will remember you, and we'll be seeing you.
Thank you. This year we lost many loved ones. We're going to recall those who passed in the last year, who were a light on our path, who blessed us by their presence, who gave us the best of themselves. And let's rise for a moment for a silent Yizkor prayer in memory of those: Betty Jarman Adelson, Robert Alwine, Stephen Mark Altman, Dean Ambrose, Lawrence Anish, Evan Behrens, Chris Canepa, Mark Clark, Cynthia Cohen, Robert Cohen, Stephen Crawford, Ronald Dahlkart, Sheila Dim, William Friedkin, Bud Friedman, Edith Glaug, Stephen C. Grossman, Cheryl Lynn Kaup Gussman, Miles Helm, Alan Kinser, Sidonia Lax, Max Lerman, Ann Lewis, Nancy Malman, Richie Morantz, Robert Marks, Michael Melwern, Jerry Moss, David Albert Pierce, Sharon Pragerson, Stephen Rodwin, Charlotte Rosenberg, Elena Rosenberg, Ilana Rosenberg, Brenda Rubens, Brenda Wasser Rubens, Robert Sanderson, Jerry Sherman, Michael Sherman, Adam Stoller, Mary Tomaslu Snyder, Toby Walenka, Donald Weinberg, and Rosalind Wyman. And Piera Farber, and any loved one, if you'll bring me a note, I'll read their names as well at the conclusion of the service. And right now we offer this Yizkor prayer, Yizkor Elohim. Dear God, remember the soul of my beloved dear one. I commit myself to preserving their memory in my heart and in my soul. I will perform acts of loving kindness, justice, and charity in their memory. May their memory be an eternal blessing for myself and all my loved ones. And we add the names this year of some from our greater community who many of us worked with: Alan Arkin, Arlene Sorkin, Astrid Gilberto, Michael Lerner, Chaim Topol, Richard Belzer, Raquel Welch, Bert Bachrach, Cindy Williams, and Bernard Kalb. The El Mole Rachamim Memorial Prayer.
El Mole Rachamim Shochina Bamerumi Hametzei Menucha Nechona Tachat Kanafei Hashchina B'Ma'alot Kedushim U'Tahorim Kezohar Hanakiya Mazhirim Et Nishama Ana ba'al harachamim yastireyem beseter kenafecha leolamim yitzror vitzror hachayim en nishmotehem haronai unachatam Shalom,
Dear God, exalted and full of compassion, grant perfect peace in your sheltering presence among the holy and pure who shine for us as the brightness of the firmament to the soul of our beloved and departed dear ones whose memory we recall this day. Dear God of mercy, remember the many mitzvot, the worthy and righteous and loving deeds they performed while together with us in the land of the living. May their souls eternally be bound up in the bond of life. As they rest in peace, and let us say, Amen. Please, repeating with me the Kaddish prayer, Yitgadal, Yitgadash, Shemei Rabbah, Bialma, Divra, Chirute, Viyamlich, Malchute, Bechaye Chom, Uvyome Chom, Uvchaye, Dechol, Bet Yisrael, Ba'agala, Uvizman, Koriv, Vimru, Amen. Yehe Shemei Rabbah Mevarach Lealam Ulalmei Almaya Yitbarach Viyishtabach Viyitpa'ar Viyitromam Viyitnase Viyitador Viyitale Viyitalal Shemei Dekutcha Berichu Leila Uleila Min kol, birhata, v'shirata, tushbechata, v'nechemata, da'amiran, bialma, v'imru, amen. Yehei, shlama, rabba, min shemaya, v'chaim, aleinu, v'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Ose shalom, v'imromav, v'yase shalom, aleinu, v'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. May God who creates peace,
may God who creates peace in the heavens above, grant peace and comfort
to all who mourn,
to all who mourn,
to all Israel,
to all Israel,
to all mankind,
to all mankind.
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. And now to remember who we are and what we are, absolute miracles. I'd like to call on Eden Contes to come up and chant for us. Never forget, we are miracles. It's a synagogue, so if you miss your cue, you don't get canceled. She could be in hair and makeup, but not having lunch. She's a bat mitzvah, she's old enough to fast. Okay. That is also a bat
to the ground through our faith we are found standing strong.
Our wonderful music director's talented daughter, who we're 12 years old. We're expecting to see her on a major television program pretty soon, so we'll all be looking for Eden. And that song comes from a traditional artist. There are a lot of traditional artists who've been composing some new Jewish music, and that was one of them. We are miracles. Our existence is a people, nothing short of miraculous. We continue our service now with the Hineni prayer. The Hineni prayer is the humble prayer of the Chazan of the Cantor, beseeching God to forgive the people for their sins. It's a prayer which speaks to our desire to be reconciled with the Creator, to heal broken places, to not allow our egos to cause us to stumble. Let's turn to page 195, if we can bring the lights up, please, so we can read. Thank you. Page 195, on the bottom of the page, please read with me this interpretive translation of Hineni. I will pray for you to help me overcome all that blocks my ability to reach you in love. And I pray that you may, in your limitless love, transform all of our troubles and misfortunes into joy and happiness, life and peace, May love of truth and peace remove all barriers to my prayers. May it be your will, eternal one, and source of all creation, that for the sake of all those who love goodness and kindness, that in your infinite benevolence, you accept all of our prayers, however awkward, with compassion. Our prayers. Please turn to page 132. And let's read in the middle of the page, "You are holy." Please join me. "You are holy, and your name is holy. May we declare your holiness each day. May all your creations be filled with reverence for you. Therefore, give honor to your people, joy and hope to those whose path is yours. May the righteous of the world soon have reason for joy. May their song rise in happiness and freedom." Our service continues with the chanting of "Ribono, Master of the Universe, this is our prayer to you."
של עולם אני מבקש ממך בכל ליבי ובזאת התפילה שתנחל אותי בדרך ישרה ותודי איני אורך התורה שתאריך איני באמתך אי וזאת כלי ובלבני ביתי לעבור אורך ביחפה ואירה אני מבקש ממך
Turn to page 197, and we rise for the chanting of the Musaf Amida, the Avot and Imahot.
Elohei Yisrael, Elohei Yaakov. Hagibur Me'anora El Elyon Gomel Chasadim Tovim Bekolei Akol Vezofer Chastei Avot Ve'imahot Umevi Geula Livnei Bneihem Leman Shmo Be'ahava again Baruch Atah Adonai Magen Abraham Vezra Tzara
Amen
Atah Gibor Yolam Adonai Vechayim Eitim Atah Rav Lehoshia Mechagel Chayim
Please be seated. Our service continues on page 199 with one of the most powerful prayers of our liturgy on these high holy days, the Unetane Tokev prayer. And on the top of the page, there's the history of the Unetane Tokev. But let's read together the bottom two paragraphs on page 199, the Unetane Tokev. Please read with me in unison. Let us declare the grandeur of this day's holiness,
a solemn
day filled with awe. This day proclaims your exalted reign based on mercy and truth. We acknowledge that you are our judge, to whom everything is known. All of our deeds, even those we forget, are remembered and recorded by you. You open the book of remembrance, and each deed recorded in it tells its own tale. Each deed is sealed by its author's own hand. The great shofar is sounded. A still small voice is heard. Even the angels are stricken with fear and trembling as they proclaim, "This is the day of judgment on which all mortals pass in review before you, like sheep that are being numbered. Indeed, in the way in which a shepherd counts his sheep and makes each one pass beneath his staff, so do you cause every human soul to pass before you. You set a limit to every creature's life, and you pass sentence upon each one."
Good.
mare gadol itaka.
Turn to page 200 and let's read responsively in the middle of the page. On the new year it is written, and on the fast of Yom Kippur it is sealed. We do not know how our fortunes will change. We do not know to whom life will be kind or to whom it will be unjust. None of us knows whose life will be cut short or whose life will be extended for another year. The only thing that we know for certain, O God, who determines the fate of each of us, is that we must bring penitence and charity and prayer to you and ask for your continued blessing on us all. Continues with the replication of the ritual of the ancient holy temple when the Kohen Gadol, the high priest, would enter before the inner sanctum and he would bow and fully prostrate himself in an offering of prayer and humility before God. And this can be found, this Avoda version of the Avoda service, on page 205. Please read with me in unison on the bottom of the page, page 205. We are called to draw out the mastery within everything to increase our wonder at the forces that formed in the universe from the beginning. We are given the truth of the Torah and the inner life that was then planted in our midst. We now kneel and bow and fall on our faces before the greatest mentor, the source of our life, the joy of our hearts, the Holy One who is stretched across the light years of heaven and undergirds the matter of earth, who spreads wings over us and nurses us with generosity. You are our God with no comparisons. We are your dear ones whose souls thirst for you, your active presence. As it says in the depths of the Torah, you will know this very day by talking deeply into your hearts that the Eternal is the God of nature everywhere, in the highest flung heavens, and undergirding the essence of the matter of the earth. Please rise as the ark will be opened for the Aleinu. Everyone, the next prayer which follows is a request. Ritzei, receive, O Lord our God, this prayer we offer. Be gracious to your people and lovingly accept our prayers. May our worship be ever acceptable to you. May our eyes behold your merciful return to Zion. Praised are you, O God, who restores the divine presence to your holy city of Zion. Ritzei.
Ritzei, ritzei,
ritzei,
ritzei, ritzei, Adonai Eloheinu, be'amecha, be'amecha.
Israel. Israel amecha. Utehil eratzon, tamid avodat, tamid avodat, Israel, Israel, amen.
At this portion in the service, it's customary to recite the ancient threefold priestly benediction. May God bless you and keep you. May God's light shine on you. May God be kind to you. And we have a beautiful new version of this melody. The blessing, it is the blessing, the priestly blessing, the three-part priestly blessing. And we all join in the response, which is amen.
Gracious to you, the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord nor turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Yevarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'yehunecha Yisa Adonai panav
presence go before you and behind you and inside you, all around you, within you.
Amen. Didn't I admonish you? You're not supposed to applaud in synagogue. What's that French expression? Gurnisht helfen. Zeloyazar. Doesn't help. Beautiful. Amen. The threefold priestly benediction. Let's continue with our humility and our continuous expression of acknowledgement of sin collectively, if not individually, with the Ashamnu prayer on page 206. So please rise as the cantor will lead us responsively in the Ashamnu confessional prayer.
Ay, 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 ay. Shaker.
Ay,
Ashanu,
Ashanu,
Sararnu,
Sararnu,
Kishinu Oref.
With me, the translation, we have trespassed. We have dealt treacherously.
We have robbed.
We have spoken slander.
We have acted perversely.
We have done wrong.
We have acted presumptuously.
We have done violence. We have practiced deceit.
We have counseled evil.
We have spoken falsehood. We have scoffed.
We have revolted.
We have blasphemed.
We have rebelled.
We have committed iniquity.
We have transgressed.
We have oppressed.
We have been stiff-necked.
We have acted wickedly.
We have dealt corruptly.
We have committed abomination.
We have gone astray.
We have led others astray.
We are light and truth, infinite wisdom, eternal goodness.
That's our real being. Yet we acknowledge our sins and shortcomings and those of the world we live in. Please be seated. We continue on pages 207 and 208 with the Vial Kulam. And let's read each of the verses for the sins and for the mistakes, beginning on page 208. For the mistakes we have committed by not seeing the spark of divinity within each person we have encountered.
And for the mistakes we have committed by not being in touch with our own divinity.
For the mistakes we have committed by trying to control those whom we love.
And for the mistakes we have committed by not being supportive to others when they got into painful spaces of being controlling.
For the mistakes we have committed by thinking we would win out of love if we gave, we would run out of love if we gave too much of it away or gave it to too many people.
And for the mistakes we have committed by hurting others to protect our own egos.
For the mistakes we have committed by not being fully present in the moment.
And for the mistakes we have committed by using spiritually as a distraction from facing our lives.
For the mistakes we have committed by giving a double message and by being manipulative.
And for the mistakes we have committed by not believing that we deserved any good.
For the mistakes we have committed by not meditating in nature when we knew we really needed to be there.
And for the mistakes we have committed by not staying home and just being quiet.
For the mistakes we have committed by being defensive and paranoid.
And for the mistakes we have committed by not trusting each other or even ourselves.
For the mistakes we have committed by being afraid to look at ourselves deeply and honestly.
And for the mistakes we have committed imagining that we had already done enough changing.
Together, for all these,
we ask God and each other for forgiveness.
Sidat rea al chet shechatanu lefanecha metzanu tayin.
And we continue, for the sins we have committed before you by being so preoccupied with ourselves that we ignore the social world in which we live.
And for the sins we have committed by being so distracted towards the political and social worlds that we ignore our own spiritual development.
For the sins we have committed by being so worn out from hearing about suffering that we closed our ears.
And for the sins we have committed by not finding appropriate outlets for our social compassion.
For the sins we have committed by allowing the environment to be destroyed for private profit.
And for the sins we have committed by allowing our food and water to be poisoned.
For the errors we have committed by not learning from the very old and the very young.
And for the errors we have committed by not sharing the communal responsibilities for child raising and elderly caretaking.
For the errors we have committed by being judgmental of others and ourselves.
And for the errors we have committed for not seeing potential unity of all people.
Please join me. For all these, we ask God and each other for forgiveness.
For forgiveness.
Page 214, this day in the Talmud, Yom Kippur, is called Yoma, the day. It is the day in which we ask God for forgiveness. We ask each other for forgiveness. We attempt to heal and move forward in life, cleansed of sin and free to explore all that is before us. Hayom, let's join with the cantors in Hayom, page 214.
Hayom, 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 hayom,
amen.
Hayom, 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 tevarcheinu, amen.
Amen.
Hayom, 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 tegadeleinu.
Amen.
Hayom, 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 tirashenu letovim.
Amen.
Hayom, 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 tetreveinu lechayim tovim.
Amen.
Hayom, 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 tishma shavateinu.
Amen.
Hayom, 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 tekabel brachamim, ratzon tfilateinu.
Amen.
Hayom, 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 hayom,
hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom, hayom